Good morning, students. I welcome you all again to the chemistry class. So till the last session we have discussed metals as one of the classification of elements, and today we will be discussing about non-metals and metalloids, the other two classification of elements. So let us first start with non-metals. Regarding the definition of non-metals, we can say that the elements that is neither malleable nor ductile and which does not conduct electricity, they are all called as non-metals. Some of the examples are hydrogen, oxygen, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, diamond. These can be some of the examples of non-metals. Now here you can see the periodic table. Here the elements which are orange in color, they are all metals, and the elements which are blue in color, they are all considered to be as non-metals, which is comparatively very less in quantity in comparison to the metals. So here in the periodic table, I have just tried to show you how can we categorize the elements as metals and non-metals. There is one more categorization, that is metalloids also, and we will be discussing it in the last slide today. Now let us start with the physical properties of non-metals. Now when we talk about the physical properties of non-metals, the first thing which comes in our mind is the state of non-metals, in which state it is present. So when we talk about non-metals, it can be present in all the three different states. It can be in solid state, it can be in liquid state, and it can be in gaseous state as well. Here you can see some of the examples in different states of matter also. The next one is, the next point regarding the physical properties is that non-metals are soft, except diamond. Diamond is one of the forms of carbon, and it is the hardest natural substance known to us. So we can say that diamond is an exception, but rest all the non-metals are soft. When we talk about the lustrous, that is shiny surface, non-metals do not have luster, or you can also say that they are all dull in appearance except iodine. Iodine is an exception here. Now when we talk about the non-metals, they are all not malleable, they are not ductile, unlike metals which we have discussed that they are all malleable and ductile. When we talk about non-metals, they are all not malleable, not ductile, they are not even sonorous. Now what do we mean by sonorous? Sonorous means when you hit it with some object, it does not produce a sound. That is one of the, you can say, the properties of metal, but here non-metals do not have that property of being sonorous. The next point is that non-metals, which are solids and liquids, they have low melting points. Similarly, they have low boiling points also, which are in the state of solid and liquid. But this is not applicable with the non-metals which are in gaseous state. And with this, non-metals are also bad conductors of heat and electricity, except graphite. Graphite is a non-metal, as I discussed earlier also, that one of the form of carbon is diamond. Similarly, one of the form of carbon is graphite also, and that is an exception. It conducts electricity. So we can say that except graphite, all other non-metals are bad conductors of electricity. Here you can see some of the pictures of examples of non-metals, and can you tell me some of the distinct features between metals and non-metals? As I have shown you the you can say the examples of metals also with the help of diagram. I told you that all the metals are basically either silver or gray in color. Here you can see that non-metals are in different colors. Like sulfur is yellow, you can see. Iodine is, you can see, bluish in color. Here I do not see the picture of iodine, but iodine is bluish violet in color. So there are some other, you can see, non-metals also which have different colors. So regarding the color of non-metals, you can say that it can be present in various colors. So students, this is a chart which you have to show and draw in your classwork copy, which shows the different, you can say, the comparison between metals and non-metals. Here are some of the properties like appearance, hardness, malleability, ductility, heat conduction and conduction of electricity. So these are six properties which you have to mention in your copy, and this is a table which compares metals and non-metal. This comparison table should be in your copy after completing the notes of metals and non-metals. Please draw this table in your copy. Like here you can see that when we talk about the appearance, metals, they are all shiny, and non-metals, they are all dull, or you can say non-lustrous. When we talk about the hardness, we all know that metals are generally hard except sodium and potassium. And when we talk about non-metals, they are generally soft except diamond. Regarding malleability, we can say metals are malleable and non-metals are not malleable. Ductility, I can say that metals are ductile and non-metals are non-ductile. When we talk about heat and electricity conduction, metals are all good conductors of heat and electricity, while non-metals, they are all poor conductors of heat and electricity. So please draw this in your copy, students. Now, as I was talking about the third categorization or classification of elements, that are metalloids. Now, when we talk about metals and non-metals, as you can see the periodic table here, you can see that one of the part is of metals, the other part is of non-metals, starting from carbon, phosphorus, sulfur. And in between, there is a stair-like structure, which is the category of metalloids. So we can say that metals in the periodic table, metals are separated from non-metals by a staircase of elements which are called as metalloids. When we talk about these metalloids, these have the characteristics some of metals also and of non-metals also. Here, as you can see, I have bordered it with red color. So all these, boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, all these are metalloids. So regarding the definition of metalloids, we can say that metalloid is an element that has the properties of metals as well as non-metals, and it can also be called as semi-metals. So students, here we come to the end of the this particular session, and in your classwork copy, you just have to write down the notes of metals, non-metals and metalloids, and a comparison chart between metals and non-metals. Thank you and have a nice day.